Follicle stimulating hormone, or FSH, is a hormone that plays a crucial role in both male and female fertility. In females, FSH stimulates the follicles on the ovary to grow and prepare eggs for ovulation. In males, FSH stimulates the production of sperm in the testicles. Fertility issues can stem from abnormal FSH levels, so it's something important to address if you're struggling to conceive. While there are medical ways to regulate FSH levels, diet can also play a key role in balancing hormones. Stay tuned to find out how changes in your diet can help improve your FSH levels. Hello and welcome to Nourish. My name is Melanie McGrice and I'm a fertility and prenatal dietitian. I run an international online dietetic clinic focused on fertility and reproductive conditions. Both too much and too little FSH can impact your fertility. There are many reasons for abnormal FSH levels, so it's best to chat with your doctor to discuss possible explanations and explore different treatment options. But whether or not you're using medical interventions, optimizing your FSH naturally through the power of nutrition can only help to achieve your goals faster. Today, I'll share with you my top 5 dietary and lifestyle tips for improving FSH levels. Number 1, ensure you're getting adequate omega-3. Research has shown that omega-3 fats may help decrease abnormally high FSH levels in women with a healthy BMI index of between 18.5 to 25. In one study, supplementation with high-dose omega-3s for just 1 month decreased women's FSH levels by almost 30%. Secondly, eat more green leafy vegetables. We all know that vegetables are good for us in general, but sadly, many of us don't meet the recommended quantities. Veggies contain a variety of vitamins and minerals that help support a healthy endocrine system and in turn may help to improve FSH levels. Although this hasn't really been tested thoroughly enough, the nutrients and antioxidants in green leafy vegetables are known to support fertility and facilitate a healthy pregnancy regardless, so I think it's definitely worth adding extra to your diet. To get more greens in, you could try blending kale with other fruits into a smoothie for brekkie, add a handful of mixed lettuce leaves to a salad at lunch, or add some Asian veggies such as bok choy or wonbok to a stir fry for dinner. You can also download my free fertility meal plan, which includes loads of delicious ways to prepare veggies. Just go to melaniemcgrice.com/fertility. Now, thirdly, maintain a healthy weight. You see, being either over or underweight can have a significant impact on our hormones. Being overweight in some cases can contribute to low FSH levels. In fact, one study showed that women who lost just 7% of their total body weight through diet and lifestyle changes saw a significant increase in their FSH. Being underweight can also cause low FSH and fertility issues. In underweight women, the brain may not produce enough gonadotropin-releasing hormone, which is a hormone that tells the pituitary gland to release FSH. And this means that ovulation can't occur. Female athletes, and also those who work out regularly, are also at higher risk of not producing enough FSH. Losing or gaining weight can be a difficult task to do on your own. So if you're worried about your weight and you have suboptimal FSH levels, then I'd really encourage you to book in to see one of our experienced fertility dietitians who can help tailor a plan unique to your needs. Fourthly, try some maca root. Maca is a root vegetable that belongs to the cruciferous vegetable family, so it's related to other veggies like cauliflower and broccoli. Its popularity stems from claims of it being able to boost fertility by balancing hormones, improving libido, and increasing pregnancy rates. There are a few studies that support these claims, but much more research needs to be done before we take them as fact. If you'd like to learn more, I have done a video about maca root, so check it out. Now, if maca can balance hormones, the question is, can it improve FSH levels? Well, there is some evidence to suggest that it can. For example, one study which was on perimenopausal women found that taking a Maca supplement for 2 months saw a significant increase in their FSH levels. Maca is considered a safe food or supplement to take and is commonly found in health food shops. You can buy it in a powder form as well, which can be used in baking or added to smoothies. And number 5 is to stress less. Now, although this is a bit out of my realm of expertise, it would be remiss of me if I didn't mention stress in this video, because stress can have a massive impact on our hormones, including FSH. When we're stressed, our bodies release stress hormones, which can throw other hormones out of balance. So take this video as permission to indulge in a bit of self-care and commit to decreasing your stress levels. I know it's much easier said than done, but just do your best. Now, I hope that you've found this video helpful and that you've learned a bit more about a few of the diet and lifestyle changes that can impact FSH levels. If you'd like to learn more about how diet can impact fertility, make sure that you subscribe to my channel and have a look through some of the other videos. I look forward to seeing you again soon. Hang on, not Andrew, your partner, because that'd be weird. Maybe just if you're struggling to conceive. In underweight, I'm rushing a bit, so I need to take a breath.